It was the life Samuel could have had.
I just turned 63 a few days ago, Samuel said.
That would have been the card Mrs. Parsons bought. He said he got a card from his mother every year. That's when Kevin asked about the rumours.
What was wrong with your mother? Why did your father take you away?
Samuel's expression turned very embarrassed and sad, and he couldn't look at us. But all he said was that it was family pressure.
People had attitudes we don't find acceptable these days, he said,
but he hastened to make clear that his father supported Mrs. Parsons all his life, right up until only weeks before he died.
That'd be the $100 every month, I'd say.
I suppose Samuel was torn between his family wishes and his mother. It goes without saying that it's obviously a very real shame he left it for so long before he did something about it. Any rate, he's going to renovate Mrs. Parsons' house and move in, so he says. Kevin's volunteered to help him, though I don't know when he'll have the time because he's joined a rowing club of late and is often up and away before sunrise. Now that I've thought about things, Cecily, it's as clear as the nose on my face that poor Mrs. Parsons was treated dreadfully simply because some people didn't approve of her type. Before Samuel left, he said,
I'm glad you're still alive.
And I said, probably only for a few more years.